So, hey everyone, welcome back to the Network Podcast. Today is not going great for me. Between having audio issues and then the technical issue of trying to find my mouse, and earlier today I was just doing some chores, which isn't that bad, but I was crammed into a very small space, and that does not work for me. The one bit of solace that I have right now is eating my chicken, and that's pretty fitting, because today we're going to be making a fast food tier list. How's that for a segue?
That is peak.
So, I'll be honest, I don't think I've been to many fast food places, so I'm going to need you guys to help me out here.
Sir, yes, sir.
All right.
Okay.
All righty.
So first up, we have A&W. I thought that was just a drink brand.
No, it's a place.
Back in the 1900s, it used to be a restaurant. It doesn't exist in California anymore, though.
Huh.
There is one in Canada that I've been to, and it is pretty good.
Pretty good?
Okay.
So
we'll let you decide that one.
Would it be here, then?
I'd say it's a C.
Okay. When I hear pretty good, I think it's in these two. Next up, we have Arby's, which I've also not been to.
I think Arby's is a B tier, in my opinion.
Will?
I've never been.
Okay.
I'm an Arby's.
Next up we have Baja Fresh.
There was one by the Ralph's down,
yeah,
down the way.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember if I've eaten it.
Yeah, same. I've been there. Well, what are your thoughts?
I'm not a fan of what they sell.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad.
It's not terrible. But there's better options.
Yeah, I'll give it high D tier, low C.
Yeah.
Okay, so between these two?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Alright. I can't remember if I've had it, which means that it was clearly unimpressive if I have.
Yeah.
So.
I've never had the next.
Blimby?
What is this?
America's Sub Shop.
Never had it.
Never seen that.
What? Bojangles?
I hear this is good. I've never been.
Bojangles. Do I look it up? What is Bojangles?
I've never had it, to be quite honest.
Bojangles. Fried chicken. Okay. Specializes in Cajun seasoned fried chicken and buttermilk biscuits that primarily serves the southeastern United States. Headquarters, Charlotte. North Carolina. Alright. So this is going into Never Had, but looks good. And then that's Boston Market.
I probably had something from there.
Oh, the Boston Market?
The Rotisserie Kitchen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
You do not get to call yourself Boston Market and exist in Golden, Colorado. That is not how this works.
That's how it works now.
I never had that. I thought that was something else.
Never had it? Okay. Burger King.
F tier.
Okay, yeah, I'm okay with that. Let's put it in F tier.
Okay. Raisin Cane's.
C tier. I'm okay. Yeah.
I haven't had it yet.
Carl's Jr.
The.
I've eaten there a lot. It's definitely not bad, but it's not great either.
Yeah, I give it a C tier or a D tier. No, low. Let's put it high D tier. It's above Baja Fresh.
Okay.
It is.
Checkers. What is Checkers?
I think that's also a chicken place.
I've never had that.
Okay, well, if we've never had it, it goes into the never had tier, which is pretty simple. Chick-fil-A. Man, I love myself. I mean, I'm literally eating chicken right now, so.
I think it's a. I personally think it's not. I think Raising Cane's is better than Chick-fil-A.
So where would you?
Let me settle the argument. I've never had Cane's. Chick-fil-A number one.
Okay. I personally think.
What do you think?
I think Chick-fil-A is good, but I don't think I've eaten at many other like chicken places. So.
Where would you put it?
I don't know, probably here.
Okay, I could go with, yeah.
Where?
There.
Here?
I'd settle. I'd be okay with that.
Okay. Chipotle.
D tier. Low D. Yeah. Okay, F tier. I'm rolling.
Above
with
Burger
that.
King.
Above Burger, yeah.
Okay. Church's Chicken.
It was pretty mid when we went for service. I would give it above Carl's Jr. and below Cane's.
Okay, so here?
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah.
Cookout, fresh hamburgers.
I've never been to that one.
Yeah, I don't know if I've been there.
I think it's another southern thing, I think.
Okay. Culver's. Never been.
Never heard of it.
Andrew?
Nope. Never been to that one either.
The never had tier is getting filled up pretty quickly. All right,
yeah,
next up,
like
Del Taco.
From 30 years ago.
D.
I've never eaten there.
Del Taco?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah, I'll put it. I'm okay with that.
Okay, so here, where in the D tier?
I'd say
above Baja.
Above Baja.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Next up is Denny's.
I give it above Cane's. Yeah, I don't know. Wait, I feel like Denny's does not qualify as a fast food restaurant because they take your order.
It's a fast food place.
It's just dine-in fast food. There's places like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot of the Taco Bells, at least the ones that I know, have a place to sit down.
So where is it going? Here?
I'd say so.
Okay, because I
haven't had Cane's.
Yeah,
before.
I'm okay with that.
I don't think I've ever eaten at Denny's.
Okay, out of the pizza restaurants, I think Domino's is a solid B tier. I don't think it's that bad.
I think it's above Arby's. That's just, I mean, I.
Yeah, I
think I'm content with that.
I have like half a pound of Domino's right in my hand right now.
Domino's is the one that has like the garlic salt or whatever on the crust, right?
Maybe.
Well, yeah, yeah, try. That's the one. That
yeah.
Is
yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm operating purely off of memory. Next up, Dairy Queen.
The best.
Really?
I love it.
Dairy? I've never been there, actually.
So.
The one in Canada, S plus.
Okay. My one experience with a Dairy Queen is walking by it constantly at a place called Fiesta Village. And basically, like, one of the summer camps I went to constantly took us on field trips to, like, laser tag or to the beach and stuff. And one of the more frequent ones was Fiesta Village, but we were not allowed to bring money or anything. And we were never allowed to eat at the Dairy Queen. But I remember walking by it all the time and being like, man, I really want some ice cream.
Dang. I mean, I've never been, so I can't really say.
Actually, have I eaten at a Dairy Queen's? I might have on the way back from a trip.
Okay.
I don't remember.
Take you guys to the one in Canada.
All right, so take us to Canada first, and then...
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so next up is El Pollo Loco.
I personally think this is a low D tier, in my opinion.
Will, where do you think it goes?
It's either low C or
D. The thing about El Pollo Loco is you have to take their food and cook it yourself. Like, if I buy chicken there, I make a quesadilla out of it, and it's like it gets moved up to high C tier, but like that's not fast food anymore.
Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Firehouse Subs.
I've never been there.
Founded by firemen.
I don't think I've had it.
All right, it's going here then. Five Guys Burgers and Fries.
Based on food taste, I'd say it's above Chick-fil-A, but. I give it highest. Yeah, I think it'd be okay with that. I'm good with that.
I have probably had it. I just don't remember.
It's
okay.
It's kind of expensive.
So, it's down to you, Andrew.
Yeah, you put it there. I think that's acceptable.
Here? Okay.
Yeah.
Next up is IHOP.
I've never been there, so I can't say.
I think...
Below Denny's.
Below Denny's, above Cane's? Right,
like, anywhere below Denny's.
Okay.
It is the inferior Denny's.
Okay. Is it above Cane's?
I don't know.
We'll just put it here, then. Next up, the local goat.
The goat.
Oh, yes. I'm fine with
that. Contentions? Any contentions?
Clear option.
Any contentions? Because otherwise it's just going there. Next up, Jack in the Box.
Give it between A and W. It's been so many years, dude. Yeah, it's been a while for me too, but I give it below A and W and Chick-fil-A.
Is it better than Denny's though?
Probably.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess I should have clarified for people who are just listening to the podcast rather than watching us make it. The local goat is In-N-Out Burger, and it is very good.
Yes, that's just the rule of the jungle.
Yeah, In-N-Out is just very good, especially for fast food. Next up, we have Jersey Mike's, though.
Jersey Mike's. Now, I am not a Jersey Mike's fan.
I don't think I've eaten there, so...
I don't remember.
Alright. Who has? Is it just you, Andrew?
I've never had it. I mean, I've had it like once, you know what I mean, type of thing.
Okay. So, clearly it wasn't impressive if you've had it once.
No, it was... I think it's worse than Chipotle, in my opinion.
Okay. Is it better than Burger King?
A lot of things are better.
Yeah, I don't think it's that. Because they have some options that are, like...
Okay. Next up, we have Jimmy John's.
I've never had it.
Probably same.
Alright, it's going there, then. Jollibee. This, I think, is a... Didn't those chains never turn out in the Philippines?
Yeah, I like this one. I'd give it, like, high B tier, or...
Okay, so now you're gonna need to decide, is it better than Arby's?
Yeah, it's better than Arby's.
Is it better than Domino's?
Yeah, I would eat there before Domino's.
Does it go in this tier, though?
Probably not. That's probably... A lot of people probably would not agree with
okay.
that.
Okay. next up, we have KFC, home to the bucket that ruins lives.
This is a... I don't know. I think it's... I give it the highest of C tier. It's definitely better than Chick-fil-A.
Will?
Whoa.
Yeah, that's Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
you two duke it out. I have...
Their chicken sandwich.
It may have just been I got the worst, like, most awful, like, disgusting slop from KFC. Because I don't see how that could happen. But I may have just gotten a bad bucket.
I don't think I've eaten at KFC, so it's up to you guys, really.
I mean, I don't see it, but
where would you put it?
Based off the bucket I had, I would say mid to low C.
Okay, I'll settle for the mid.
We can put it better than AMW.
Okay. So you two have collectively decided that Chick-fil-A is better than KFC.
Absolutely.
Okay, so...
We agree to disagree.
Next up is Little Caesars.
That's alright.
Like, I barely ever had it. I'd give it, like... Yeah, right there. This is acceptable.
Okay. I'll be honest, I just bring it to the middle, and if that works out, it works out. Long John Silver's, what is this?
I've never
been...
I have eaten at McDonald's once.
F tier.
And
no,
I
McDonald's
hated it.
Good.
I hated it.
F tier.
You guys are trolling.
I hated it.
Better than Burger King.
No, that's definitely better than anything in the D tier.
No, okay. So the one time I ate at McDonald's, I think I almost threw up afterwards. It was vile.
You guys, I don't know.
Every
what
time
about.
I ate at McDonald's, I almost threw up.
The one and only time I've eaten there, I threw up.
Dude, you guys are
so.
You guys are coping. It is not. Bad.
I'm not coping. I literally almost did. The onions, the onions on the top of the burger were gross.
They may have improved in the last 8 years, but I'm not going to test it.
Yeah. So, Will and I both wanted an F. Where would you put it, Andrew?
I would put it, like, probably above IHOP.
Okay, so you'd put it here.
Yeah.
Will and I want it down here.
Yeah.
So to compromise...
The settlement is the top of D tier.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, that isn't really how compromising works, but sure, we can do that.
Yes, it is, Daniel.
No, I mean, like, technically, it would be two-thirds of the way. So it would be, like, here, but...
But two-thirds is a weird number, so put it down in F.
next up, we have Mo Southwest. Noodles Company.
Never had that.
I've never heard of it either.
Same.
Panda. Panda Express.
I don't know. I mean,
I think it's alright.
It's actually not. It's not terrible.
Yeah,
it's definitely not good either.
I mean, it's fast food, but it could be worse.
I would leave it there below Denny's.
Below Denny's? Yeah, I can work with that. I can work with that. I personally rate it higher, but I don't have much stake in the game. Panera Bread.
Oh, Panera Bread, I don't know. I'd put it right above Panda Express. But that's just personally me.
Yeah, I'll put it right below it.
Alright, yeah, I'm good with that. I can roll with that.
Yeah. Papa John's.
The Day of Reckoning.
Why is Papa John himself crossed out?
I don't think I'm a big Papa John's fan. Out of all of the pizza stores on this list, I think it's the worst one.
I think I dislike Pizza Hut more, but that's just because Pizza's just too greasy
really?
For
I like
me.
Pizza Hut the best.
I think Pizza Hut's just too greasy for me. We can hash this out in a moment. Where would we put Papa John's? I don't think I've eaten there.
Above McDonald's.
I can work with that. PDQ. What is PDQ?
I don't know. All right, I'll be. I'll
PDQ is another chicken shop.
I've never had it.
Southwest
either.
Or not Southwest? South. South.
In the South. Penn in Station South. East Coast Subs. It's on the East Coast.
I've never had it.
Worst coast.
Pizza Hut.
True. It is the worst coast.
I would put Pizza Hut above Domino's personally.
You can put it next to Domino's. How about that?
Okay.
Because I'm also kind of a fan, but, like, not as much of a fan.
I don't think it's bad by any means. I just think I get sick of eating it the fastest because it's just so greasy.
Fair enough, sir.
Alright, Popeyes.
Popeyes. I think it's better than KFC.
We know where to put it, then.
Portillo's? Portillo's?
I don't think I've ever had it.
Okay, Potbelly Sandwich Shop.
I've heard of it.
I haven't.
I think I've eaten at it.
So it's going here?
I guess so.
Going in the... Okay.
Yeah, I never had that. I never had the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I've had Shake Shack. I've had Subway.
Okay, so this, so these are going into here.
Yes.
I've had Shake Shack too. So.
How was it? How was Shake Shack?
I give it.
Panera area?
Panera?
Yeah.
Above or below?
Right there, in between though.
In between? Okay.
I'm okay, yeah.
So I guess sorry to all of you, Qdoba, Quiznos, Roy Rogers, Sbarro, and Schlotsky's Cafe.
Jack used to eat Quiznos a lot. I don't know anything about it.
Yeah.
I think it's a pizza place. I'm not sure.
No, it's a sub. Place. Yeah, it's a sub place, I think.
Will.
I don't know.
Pizza sandwich, basically the same thing.
Yeah, they have toppings on it.
Yeah, that's the only thing to compare. If it has toppings, might as well be a sandwich.
Might as well be a pizza. What do you mean?
So are sandwiches right, pizza or pizza sandwiches?
I've never had the next four.
Sheets. Yeah. Okay. Skyline. Okay. Sonic.
Like a car? I haven't had Sonic myself.
I I don't know if I've eaten at Sonic.
I've seen the commercials.
Chili, they should sell chili dogs. Steak and Shake.
Never had it.
Has anyone eaten at Swenson's?
Nope.
Taco Cabana.
Dude, what is this, Mike? I have to.
Torchy's Tacos. Again?
Nope.
Waffle House.
Nope.
I've only heard good things about Waffle House.
Never had Whataburger. Never had the last five.
Yeah, I haven't had the last any of them.
Have I eaten at Wiener Schnitzel?
Why do I?
Have you had a? Never mind.
Ask it.
Nope. Never had Wiener Schnitzel either. By the way, have you?
Oh.
Let me see if. You know what? I have no idea. This is gonna go in here too. All right. So the last three we have are Subway, Taco Bell, and Wendy's.
Subway, I give it mid C tier, above IHOP, below Cane's.
Yeah.
Okay, so here.
That works for me. Yeah.
All right. Next up is Taco Bell.
Yeah.
I'd say it's above Jack.
That's a hit or miss for me. Personally.
If it's a hit, I'd say it's above Jack in the Box.
But yeah, if it's a miss, it's like it's below like El Pollo Loco.
Yeah.
So if it's a hit, it's
IHOP for sure.
If it's a hit, it's here. If it's a miss, it's down here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Next to Little Caesars.
So let me just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so this is literally where the middle is.
Well, you can move it to the left one.
Okay. Finally, we have Wendy's. Again, I don't think I've eaten here, so.
I have not.
Andrew? Yes.
Which one?
Wendy's.
I would put it right above IHOP.
Okay. Perfect. So, this is our collective tier list of fast food restaurants.
Acceptable.
Of course, we have the one and only goat of In-N-Out at the top. Dairy Queen's also goat. Up here because Will. B tier only has five, and fittingly in fifth place in B tier is Five Guys.
We meant to do that.
Yeah, definitely intentional. The C tier has a lot of chicken places. With Chick-fil-A, Popeyes, KFC, Cane's, Caesar's. Yeah. Honestly, this looks pretty good. The D tier, F tier, by far our most filled tier is the Never Had tier.
Yep.
Sorry to all of you that enjoy any of these places or any of the ones in the lower tiers, but also you're just wrong. So, yeah.
Yeah, sorry to the worst coast and the middle of the states. Sorry.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
The Midwest isn't even in the middle of the West. It's east.
Okay.
Yep. I had to bring that up. So, anyway, we have another fast food tier list that has... Yeah.
But a lot of these look the same. It looks like the exact same thing with more things we've never had.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, what is Blake's? I assume that says Blake's right below Checkers.
I guess... Yeah. Are there any places here that we recognize that we would put anywhere in the previous tier list?
That weren't in the previous tier list?
Oh, Timmy's.
Timmy's?
I've never had Timmy's. Oh, all of these, yeah.
Timmy's S tier.
This? Which one?
The importance.
Right, oh, got it. Okay, so this would go into this. Yes, now, sir! here's the one question I have for you. Is this the order?
That's the order.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's how it has to be.
Okay, that makes sense. I just needed to make sure you were on the right side of history here.
I'm you had to make sure you were either correct or just wrong.
Yeah, we definitely aren't showing any bias with us constantly putting in and out at the top.
There's no bias here, surely.
So I guess since... We went through the fast food tier list a lot faster than we did the drinks, and I think that's just because we've been to less fast food places. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, there's just less contention amongst the three of us when we've gone to less of the places compared to drinking many different drinks. So.
Truth. This is the truth.
God, speaking of drinks, water.
Same.
Mm-hmm.
Won't hair.
So, I guess for the last bit here, we might as well just,
the shorter one.
Well, no, I was gonna say we could just go over some food-related questions. Such as, but not limited to, is a hot dog a sandwich?
Oh, I think that's a no.
Okay. Elaborate. Why isn't a hot dog a sandwich? What makes a sandwich a sandwich?
I don't think it's a sandwich just because it's like it's been identified as like something else. Like it's its own class, you know?
Okay.
Plus, like a sandwich Elaborate. Has like open ends on all four sides, you know, usually, or like more open ends.
So the thing that makes a sandwich. What is a sandwich?
Okay, I guess technically, like, a sandwich is two pieces of bread with something in between it, so...
Sandwich, an item of food consisting of two pieces of bread with meat, cheese, or other filling between them.
Yeah, so I guess by definition it's a sandwich, but I don't think it's a sandwich.
Okay.
That's just how it's gonna be.
So, there is another definition for sandwich, and why is this the first... or the example sentence? When you sandwich something, it's when you squeeze someone or something between two people or things.
Okay, that did not need to be the example sentence.
Why is that the example sentence? The girl was sandwiched between two burly men in the back of the... Why is that the example sentence, Google? Or Oxford Languages? Or the dictionary? Why is that your example sentence?
The dictionary on to something weird.
Oh, wait, okay, so this is... it's a matter of bread. It's called a hot dog when it's on a bun. It's called a hot dog when it's not. The bun is irrelevant to the nature of the hot dog, therefore... Okay, so basically the wiener is the hot dog, which makes it not a sandwich.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you prefer chewy cookies or crunchy cookies?
Chew.
Oh, chewy.
Yeah, okay. I think we all agree on this then. Is cereal a soup?
Is cereal a soup?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but no.
Okay. Will?
I don't know.
Answer the
question. I do not dare test with trivial matters.
Okay, then, Mr. Enlightened Being. What is your opinion on what a soup is, then?
Something I don't drink or eat.
Okay.
Wait, what was the question?
Is cereal a soup?
Oh, we're still on this one? No, it's not.
Okay.
I thought that was answered.
My status for a little bit was, is ketchup a, tomato soup? Or, no, not a tomato soup.
Yeah.
It was something along that line. I forget exactly what it was now. Now I'm just trying to find food-related trivia. What are...
Food-related trivia?
I looked it up, and the first thing that comes up for me is 392 food trivia questions. Why is it so specific?
Why is it so specific?
Why is it 392 food trivia questions?
I don't know.
Only?
Yeah. Okay. There is a lot of them here. Huh. Okay, would you like to try to do some of the food trivia questions?
What does that mean?
As an example, one of the questions is, retired in the 21st century, its finger-looking good had been the slogan for over 50 years for what restaurant chain?
KFC.
KFC, yeah. That's an easy one.
Another one of them is, what food is the Scoville scale used to measure spiciness?
Wait, what food? Peppers, right?
Yes, but yeah. There's a specific pepper.
Scoville peppers.
No.
The Carolina Reaper has a Scoville score.
Yeah, all peppers do. They that's do. That's how they're measured. It's
I'm confused on the question.
For what food is the Scoville scale used to measure spiciness? It's, I mean, the answer is peppers, but it's chili peppers specifically.
Oh, yeah. Oh my bad.
No, no, no. It's yeah.
I didn't. I forgot about that part.
Huh. Another one of them is, one of Andy Warhol's most famous artworks is a set of 32 canvases, each bearing an image of a red and white soup can from what company?
Campbell's?
Yes. Yes, it is Campbell's.
I was gonna say, who?
Andy Warhol is the famous artist who drew soup, or painted soup, or whatever. Found on many types of sushi, nori is the Japanese name for the edible species in the red algae genus Pyropia. Frequently used in the format of dried sheets, what is the English term for this edible ingredient?
Seaweed, bruh.
Yep. Very fancy way to just say seaweed.
Yes. Like, where are they going with
this? The edible species in the red algae genus Pyropia. Mm-hmm. I love...
You lost me as soon as you said genus. I literally did the funny sleeping.
Okay. What distilled alcoholic spirit has an English name derived from the diminutive form of the Slavic word for water? In essence...
Vodka.
Yeah, it is vodka.
Derived from the Slavic word for water is crazy.
Uh-huh. In essence, this word, this means the word can be interpreted as little water.
Little, yeah, there is a little water in that.
Dramatically different from today's sweet fruit associated with summertime, which large fruit was cultivated for hundreds of years simply for hydration purposes rather than food? So basically, what is a fruit that is sweet associated with summertime that has high water content?
Was I right?
Watermelon.
It is watermelon.
That was right.
It is watermelon. Yeah. That makes sense. I guess watermelon is, 90% water? So because water from rivers was constantly getting contaminated because they didn't have sewage systems and they just threw their out into the street? And it would go down into rivers and stuff. That makes sense. There's a specific snack often associated with a type of entertainment venue. This snack has been created for thousands of years. Yeah. Yep. It's popcorn.
Popcorn.
What is the common name for the food that is technically steamed balls of crushed durum wheat semolina? Originated as a... It has a lot of C's in it. It has a repetitive C name.
Okay.
Born.
No.
Wait.
I don't remember the question.
Wait, where did it originate in?
It originated as a... I'm definitely not going to pronounce this correctly. Maghrebi dish served with a stew spooned, and it has a repetitive C name.
I don't know.
Basically, the name of this food is the same word twice. And it starts with a C. Would you like me to...
Yeah, I don't know this one.
It is couscous.
Oh, never heard of it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, I've had couscous before. And it's not bad. What popular condiment would you use as a base for a remoulade or a tartar sauce? This, I don't think, is that difficult.
Mustard.
No.
Ketchup.
No.
Wait, what?
What popular condiment would you use as a base for a remoulade or a tartar sauce?
Mayonnaise.
Yep, mayo.
Mayonnaise.
What American fast casual restaurant, formerly known as Boston Chicken, was founded in Newton, what is that? Massachusetts in 1984. While the company headquarters have since moved to Colorado, the chain sticks to its Boston namesake roots.
I wonder who that could be.
We just saw it not too long ago.
A market that could possibly be in Boston.
It is.
But also not
the market of Boston, located in Golden, Colorado.
Oh, we like to hear.
Okay. The next question is, what is the only fruit with seeds on the outside?
Strawberry.
Yep.
Strawberry.
Yeah. North Carolina's Piedmont region has historically been known for the growth of what crop?
Wheat.
No.
Corn.
With companies such as Philip Morris, Reynolds American, and Lorillard still having a heavy presence within the state.
That's great. I definitely know those things.
Here's your hint. Drugs.
Opium.
No.
Weed.
No. I don't even know if weed is legalized in North Carolina, I'll be honest.
Yeah, I don't know either.
The answer is tobacco.
I'm technically correct.
That should have been a...
I don't know why that's in food trivia. Do people eat tobacco? I know people chew it, but do you consume it? Do you just go, that was a good piece of tobacco. Yummy. There is a dessert with slightly mysterious origins. Is it from France, Spain, or England? That is also known as a burnt cream or Trinity cream.
Creme brulee.
Yeah. It's creme brulee.
Oh, I would not.
The signature McDonald's breakfast sandwich, resembling a mass assembly version of an Eggs Benedict, is the egg blank introduced in 1972. Its name is a one-word combination of the McDonald's brand and a small domed cake made of batter. What is it?
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
No. It is the egg blank.
What? Isn't it just called the McEgg?
No.
Okay.
The signature McDonald's breakfast sandwich is the egg. Andrew?
What? I didn't hear that.
I feel like you should be able to get this. The signature McDonald's breakfast sandwich is...
The sausage egg McMuffin.
Yep, it's the egg McMuffin.
Yep. I definitely didn't.
What food of the three bears did Goldilocks eat?
Ah, yes.
Soup. You got chilled.
It's what?
Porridge. Mama bear.
No.
Oh. Porridge.
Yeah, it's porridge. It's porridge.
I thought you meant which bear.
No. And besides, she liked the not the too kid. Hot, not too cold one that the kid was eating.
The baby bear.
If you take cabbage, cut it finely, and ferment it, the output is typically what German side dish?
Oh, bro, sauerkraut?
Yeah, it's sauerkraut.
Lettuce.
No.
I was going to say kimchi, but then you said German.
Yep. What popular two-word cable TV channel owned by Discovery offers shows such as Chopped and Iron Chef America?
The cooking channel?
No.
Bro, what? Ain't no way.
It's the Food Network.
The Food Network.
That's three words, bro.
No, Food Network.
Oh. Dude, oh my god, I knew that, dude. That's so stupid. I just said the cooking channel, even though I knew, because me and my parents were always called the cooking channel.
No, it's the Food Network.
Food Network.
Okay. No, this isn't food trivia, unless people eat this. Although now it formally does not stand for anything, the organization AABB was founded in the U.S. in 1947 as the American Association of Blank Blank. The group works closely with the FDA and provides technical help in regulations regarding blood donations and storage across the country, while also accrediting transfusion sites.
I don't even want to know anymore.
AABB stands for the American Association of Blood Banks. Why is that related to food? Do people eat blood?
I don't think it is, Daniel.
Although MCI was once known as one of the largest long-distance phone providers in America, the M in the name once stood for what nine-letter word often more associated with reheating food?
Microwave.
Yep.
Microwaves.
What popular two-word Thai dish? I'll be honest, I think that's all you need.
Mm-hmm.
What is a popular two-word Thai dish with Thai in the name? Pizza margherita is a typical Neapolitan pizza made with tomatoes, mozzarella cheese, salt, extra virgin olive oil, and what culinary herb?
What?
Pizza margherita, like Italian pizza.
I've never had that. Oh, margherita. I didn't hear. No, I just didn't hear what the first couple words.
Pizza margherita is a typical Neapolitan pizza made with tomatoes, mozzarella cheese, salt, extra virgin olive oil, and what culinary herb?
Grease.
That is not.
Oh, no.
I want to see you grow grease, then.
I can grow grease.
Okay, do it.
Go to a McDonald's.
Okay, and so order. What culinary herb is perhaps associated with Italian foods?
Italian foods? Oregano, basil.
Yep, there you go. The answer is basil. Basil is on pizza. Unless you have the gene that makes basil taste... No, it's cilantro that I'm thinking of. Some people have a gene that makes cilantro taste like soap. That is an actual thing.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm. What's another one? What 10-letter coffee drink has less milk than a latte?
An espresso?
No. Well, 10-letter.
Black coffee?
What did you say, Will?
Cappuccino.
Yep. It is. Dang, it is the cappuccino.
W, man, he knows his coffee.
He does.
I know my coffee. I've never had a drop of it in my life.
I am curious if you guys know this. What privately held corporation, founded in 1911 in Tacoma, Washington, is a conglomerate that not only its namesake bars popular around the world, but also has M&Ms, pet food, and animal care services? Do you know what the conglomerate that not only has popular candy bars in its name around the world, but also owns M&Ms?
Mr. Beast.
No. Mr. Beast does not own M&Ms, Will.
Does he? You never know.
No, he doesn't.
We don't know that.
There is a specific candy bar. Actually, okay.
Kit Kat.
Here's the hint. Actually, I think Kit Kats are owned by this company, too. I'm not totally sure. It is named after a planet.
Pluto. Mars bars.
Yep, it's Mars. Okay.
Mars, I haven't had one of those before.
Yes, but Mars is also the name of the overarching company that owns Mars bars, M&M's, pet food, and animal care services.
Awesome.
Yeah. Spanakopita is a savory pastry typically filled with spinach and feta cheese. Spanakopita translates almost directly as spinach pie. In its home country's language, what is the home country?
Greek? I don't know.
Yeah, it's Greece.
Okay, lucky guess.
All right. Although back, collar, and jowl all exist as cuts of this cured meat, the most popular is steaky, which comes from the pork belly and is often served as a side dish during breakfast. What is the type of the salt-cured pork with its name derived from Old High German word for buttock? For the butt.
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
Yeah, it's bacon. It's bacon.
Bacon.
Yeah, bacon. Woo. What four-letter word is often used as the common name for several edible kinds of mollusks?
Oh?
What four-letter word is often used as the common name for mollusks when the mollusk is edible?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know anything about mollusks. What is a mollusk?
Shell. Look up what a mollusk is. Shell is five letters, Will.
I don't know. Mollusk.
Yeah.
Just guessing words.
I think you guys should be able to get this one.
A mollusk is a vertebrate.
Yeah, but like, if you were eating one, what would it be called? No.
If you were...
Neck.
Yeah, if you were eating a mollusk, what would it be called?
Food?
Bro.
Tell me I am he's wrong. Right, right. Tell he's me right. I am okay. Wrong.
Clam.
What? A clam is a mollusk?
Yeah. Yeah. Specifically bivalve mollusk, but I figured that wasn't gonna help.
Actually, it might have, because if you type in bivalve
mollusk. Okay,
in
sure. My bad. My bad.
Clam shows up.
My bad. My bad. Let's do this. Let's find one last one, shall we?
Okay. Yeah. Find the good one. Find the best.
Okay. Chicago and Jimmy Dewar worked as a manager at a Hostess factory when he created a banana cream pastry in 1930. During World War II, when bananas were scarce, vanilla cream replaced the banana filling. What is the product?
Twinkies.
Yep. It's Twinkies.
Dang, that's a classic.
It certainly is a classic.
Not good for the health.
What?
Yeah, I mean, if you keep eating those, you might not stand that 10% for longer.
Nah, just reach 10% faster.
I don't think that's the case.
You're clearly not in the 10%, because you don't think that's how it works, but, you know.
A snack brand in 1968 features individual pieces shaped as hyperbolic paraboloids so that they fit perfectly in their vessel. What is the snack brand?
Hyperbolic?
Hyperbolic paraboloids. A snack brand introduced in 1968 features individual pieces shaped as hyperbolic paraboloids so that they fit together perfectly in their vessel.
Oh, what is Pringles.
The yep, it's Pringles.
You can look up what the hell a hyperbolic paraboloid is.
Yeah, a hyperbolic paraboloid is just the shape that a Pringle happens to be.
That's just a coincidence, Daniel.
Seems to be that way.
Listen, that's just what the trivia had. So, that, well, for the record, that is a hyperbolic paraboloid.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I eat those.
You eat those?
I eat those.
That's crazy. Oh, yeah, do you guys actually...
They're called
Pringles. Do you guys actually have a, favorite type of apple?
Apple. No, I'm not an apple.
You're not a what? Did he... Is he gone? Andrew? Uh-oh. I think we might have lost... you cut out.
Oh, I said something. I said... I don't really eat apples, but I drink, like, apple juice and apple pie and stuff.
Okay. Yeah. Do you have a favorite type of apple, Will?
The ones I eat.
Do you know what type they are?
They're squishier.
Squishier.
For the longest time, I ate just the, like, lunchbox Fiji apples. Those are your typical red apples. And then I think at some point I was introduced to the Honeycrisp apple, which is absolutely delicious.
Honeycrisp apple? What color is it?
It's red too, but it's, like, not as deep of a red as a Fiji apple. It has a little bit of tart to it. It's pretty sweet, though, and it's very crisp. So, that is my personal favorite type of apple. It's also apparently really expensive, but I think that might just be apples. Do you guys have
I don't know much about apples.
What do you consume fruit often?
Yeah, but not apples. Not often. I eat strawberries as my main fruit, but I don't eat a lot of fruit.
That's fair. Strawberries are really good too. I think. Oh, now I'm trying to remember. I think at some point I went to a strawberry festival. I think I might have done that twice, actually. And basically, everything there was just themed after strawberries, and it had, like, strawberry funnel cakes and strawberry-themed amusement park rides, stuff like that.
That's just weird.
What, do you not also get forced by your parents to go to places, especially when you were younger?
No.
Yes. No? I did.
You weren't forced to obliged by their every whim as soon as they were like, all right, this is what we're doing?
Not really.
Yeah, I was. I lived in an Asian household.
Still are, right?
I think this is just the difference between being an only child and being or having a sibling. You just get dragged around if you have a sibling. Because unless both kids are protesting, and even then, I don't think it matters.
We do have. Well, there is a little baby dog that ruins things.
Oh, that's true.
But he's the cutest little guy, so it doesn't matter.
Do you guys have a favorite meal?
Nope.
Favorite entree or anything like that?
I don't know. I don't have a favorite. I don't know. I like most Japanese foods, so.
I don't know. I don't think I like sushi that much, but I do really like fish. I think it might just be that I like cooked things better than raw. Might be a part of the answer. But I know that favorite food is like a typical icebreaker, so I'm trying to get more specific than just asking, oh, what's your favorite food? Because that feels too generic.
Favorite food? I don't know. I think everybody's favorite food is like almost like it's usually like a cultural thing too.
Yeah. No, that makes sense. I think mine used to be salmon.
Salmon?
Okay. Yeah. Will, for the longest time it was pizza, then it was salmon.
No.
Yeah. See, some people don't have one either. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, picky eaters have like favorites more often than non-picky eaters.
Picky is just the amount that I eat. It's not what I eat.
I am picky in what I eat, because if something tastes bad, I will not eat it.
Same.
Mm-hmm. But it very specifically has to taste bad to me. Sometimes tasting bad just means being too acidic. Or too bitter, because I don't like those.
Exactly, that's why tomatoes suck.
True. Sometimes tasting bad literally just means triggering my gag reflex and making me feel like I'm going to throw up. So, what? What is it, Will?
What is he doing? Hmm? What's he doing?
I'm just going with the listening to a song right now.
Got it.
Can't believe this guy isn't being a responsible podcast host.
I am listening to A Lot by 21 Savage.
Nice.
Yeah, I don't.
The part where J. Cole pops off.
You were just saying words.
Those are names, silly.
I know those are names. I don't. You know this about me. I exist in my own little world, basically.
Yeah, you listen to music you either can't understand or is aesthetically pleasing.
Mm-hmm. Music that was literally made to be enjoyed for long stretches of time because it is background music in video games. That is the music that I consume. I feel like that would be a pretty easy thing to do, just ranking the different genres of music, but also, how many genres of music are there?
There's a lot, like a lot get mixed in with each other.
Yeah. Let me look that up. Music genre tier list. Music genre.
It exists. I'm 100%.
Yeah, it does.
Sure.
One of them had 550 plus.
We got time.
Oh. Oh no.
Let me see.
Uh-oh.
Ooh. Let's take a peek here.
Math rock, math core.
Oh,
neo psychedeliac or psychedeliac?
There's too many
what?
Words here.
Yo, hard bop.
Hard bop, bro.
Crust punk.
Trance.
Nueva canción.
Isn't that just new songs?
Bird song. Death dream.
This guy just started saying words.
Like, I know. Shoegaze!
Hey, don't be staring at shoes while listening to songs.
New wave, no wave. Noise rock, noise core. New metal, but spelled as in, like, the Greek letter new. Pop rap, pop runk, post grunge, post hardcore, post industrial, post metal, post minimalism, post punk.
There's too many genres.
Post rock,
there.
Power pop, power violence.
There's too many genres.
What are
there's
you?
Violent. Too many. I repeat, there's many.
Dub.
Are
I like
you,
just dub.
Are you not
next
a fan of stoner metal, stoner rock, or psychedelic pop, or psychedelic rock, or psychedelic folk?
Me personally, I'm a fan of dub.
I'm a big fan of bossa. I actually do like bossa nova. We have gangster
bro
rap.
Step. There's bro step right below.
There's
bro
what?
Step. Bro step. Right
yeah,
below
dubstep,
rap.
Pro step, or bro step. There's also drum and bass. Deconstructed club.
Bubblegum bass. What?
What?
There is bubblegum bass right next to pop punk.
Yeah.
Bubblegum bass.
Awesome. We also have harsh noise, my favorite type of music. I love
that's just Justin Bieber.
Big Beat just has an image of a crab. I don't know why.
This is an awful way. This is an awful way.
Dude, this is like weird, bro. I've never even heard of 90% of these.
I've heard like combinations of all of these words before, and I definitely understand kind of what the music is, but at the same time, until I hear it, I'm not gonna understand what grindcore is.
Yeah, I don't know what grindcore is either.
Or what crouch rock is. Or
crouch rock.
Kowali? How do you pronounce this
what?
One?
Sorry, say that again.
Q-A-W-W-A-L-I.
Yeah, I've never even...
I do like that there's just bird song. Huh. You know what? Maybe we don't do this. Maybe we leave this never. We never go back to it.
Oh, I found it.
You found the tier list?
I found the tier list.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Maybe that's a next. Maybe we should do it. That's like a next podcast idea.
No.
We already have one.
We will not do it ever.
Music genres.
Oh,
this
oh,
is easier.
I found a worse one.
What is big
you found
room?
A worse...
Yes, I found dude, a worse what? One.
Check this one.
No, this one has This bop. It's
literally just the baby's song bop.
Hello, would you like to listen to Christian hip hop, Christian metal, Christian rock, or Christmas music?
All four.
Or perhaps what about Death Grind or Kronk?
What is Big Room?
How about Boom Bab or Bomba?
I'm a fan of Bomba myself.
Big Room? Big Room Bounce and Break? What is room. Big Room? What is big room music?
I don't know, but it's an S tier for me.
No, dude. What is this?
Doo-wop? Oh, it's a doo-wop. Okay, actually, I know what that is, I think.
There's too many unknowns here.
What do you mean? Are you saying you don't know what unblack metal is? How about swamp rock?
Yeah,
or sludgecore?
What about world? Just world.
Why?
You're not a fan of world music?
No, I don't. I don't think I am. I am a big fan of surf rock, though. Surf or perhaps rock. Teutonic thrash metal.
People just put words together.
Oh, I'm a big fan of prehistoric music.
That's a banger. Personally, that's S tier.
Or perhaps
And why is NRG there? I just realized that. Why is NRG there?
Nightcore and Nintendo Core. Both of them are here, and their two respective icons are Hatsune Miku and Toad with headphones.
Okay, so if I'm looking at all this right now.
Uh-huh.
Post bop, NRG and bop are all my S tiers right now, as well as prehistoric music.
Gotta have that prehistoric music. For me, it would be original soundtracks go to S tier.
Oh, we gotta have NRG in S tier.
You can't leave out the Memphis rap or Mesopotamian music.
Shout out Memphis rap.
Rap
goes crazy.
I'm such a big fan of Honky Tonk. What?
The real thing.
What is Honky Tonk?
Right, let me get you. I got you, don't worry.
Okay, you know what? Maybe we do come back to this at some point. This is funny. But I think for now, we have actually hit an hour of, the podcast.
Yes. Technical difficulties be like.
No, we've hit an hour. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I almost just fell out of my chair.
Yeah. So we started out with the food tier list, and then we went to food trivia, and then somehow music found ourselves talking about music. I have no idea how that worked.
Because I mentioned the song.
Yeah. But hey. Hope you all enjoyed this episode of the Neatwork Podcast, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.